Super Savers. Jabu, get off the field, the referee shouted across the soccer field. You know the safety regulations. No soccer togs, no shin pads, no play, the referee said sharply. Jabu walked off the field, not daring to look up and see who was watching him. He just sat there, next to the field, not even interested in how his team was doing. All he could think about was those togs and shin pads that were huge problems in his life right now. He couldn't ask his mom and dad to buy them because money was a problem. Wednesday soccer practice came, but Jabu stayed at home, avoiding the team. One person he could, however, not avoid was Gogo, his grandmother. She asked Jabu why he wasn't at his usual soccer practice. It's no use, Gogo. If I don't wear soccer shoes and shin pads, the coaches and referees won't allow me to play. Some stupid safety rules, they say, Jabu said with a mixture of anger and disappointment. Gogo gave her grandson a big hug and said nothing. On Saturday morning, the sun peeped through Jabu's curtains and shone brightly in his eyes. Jabu sighed and pulled the blankets up over his head. He was sad he was not going to soccer practice. Then he heard someone opening his door. Jabu peeped out from under his blanket to see Gogo peering in at the door. Vukani, Jabu, you lazy bones! Your soccer team is waiting for their super striker! Gogo smiled at Jabu's surprised eyes over the blankets. But Gogo, you know I won't be able to play in the match next week, so what's the use of going to soccer practice? It's too cold anyway. Gogo simply ignored his grumpiness and told him to close his eyes and hold out his hands. Jabu did as his Gogo asked. She was in such a good mood that Jabu didn't want to dampen her spirits. He felt something heavy being placed in his hands. It was box-shaped. His eyes shot open. He cautiously opened the lid and peeped inside. The very next second, the box, the lid, and a very shiny pair of brand new soccer shoes went flying through the air as Jabu jumped out of bed in excitement and shrieked, Gogo, you're the best! You're the best! No, Jabu, you're the best. The best soccer player our family has ever had. Now put on those soccer shoes and shin pads and get to your practice. Gogo giggled while being hugged by a little bouncing boy. Jabu tried them on. They fitted like they were made especially for him. Then he suddenly became quite serious. But Gogo, what money did you use to buy these? He asked with concern. Was it your pension money? You need that money to pay for your food and electricity every month. No, my boy. Your Gogo is a wise old lady. Every month, when I receive my pension money, I put a bit of it away in a savings account at my bank. I have been doing this for a few years now. The bank keeps my money safe for me and even pays me some extra money. It's called interest. Basically, it's to say thank you for saving with them, Gogo explained. But Gogo, that's very special money which should be kept for a very special occasion, not so? Jabu questioned his grandmother. Yes, my boy, you are right. And I have decided that this is my very special occasion. Wear your new soccer shoes with pride. All I ask in return is that you keep that bright smile of yours, especially when you kick that winning goal, Gogo replied with excitement. With tears in her eyes, she patted Jabu on the back and said in her pretend stern voice, Now off you go. Go on. Go make your Gogo proud.